Hello ladies and gentlemen, how do you do? Welcome to Traditional Programming Users. Now guys, for today we're going to continue talking about our Android MySQL database. And today specifically we're going to see how to work with the master detail view. Okay, we shall be obtaining our data of course from our MySQL database. We shall be showing them in a grid view. Now, for us this is the data that we shall want. You can see we have these four columns: the ID, the name, the propellant, the description, the image. Now for us what we shall do is very simple. For our master view, that is our main activity, we shall show inside our grid view. We're going to show this name right here and the image. Okay, and then now when you click it, and then it shall open for you a new activity, the detail activity, where we shall be also showing all these ones, also the propellant and of course the description inside the detail activity. So that's it. You can see right here, these are data. You can see for instance for the images we have the URLs pointing for the image. I'm having a simple website right here. You can see these are it. The website itself has the images that we're going to be showing. Now you can see for instance it is these URLs that we're going to be storing in the database. Okay, so this does it. This is what we're going to look at. Now if I come, for instance, make sure that your server is up and running. I'm using MySQL with DOM server. If I come click my fab button right here, very fast you can see it loads our data in our grid view. You can see right here we have all these. Now for instance, if I come click for instance at this one right here, you can see it's opening for us our detail activity with the name, okay, propellant, and of course the description. It's of course obtaining them from our database. For instance, if we come right here, you can see with this pizza spacecraft, if you come right here, you can see the description is right here, okay, the propellant, and of course the image right here, and the name. It's obtaining them from the database and then showing them inside our detail activity. Okay, so this is what we're going to look at. What of, for instance, if we want to show let's say the herbal. Now for herbal we can come, you can see right here, this is the description, the propellant, the name over here. So if we come click the herbal, okay, you can see the description, propellant, and of course the name. So this is it. This is what we're going to be looking at. Okay, you can see our master detail interface. And take note, by the our images, we are loading them lazily using the Picasso library. Okay, so this is what we're going to look at for enterprise. You can see right here, it's short description. This is it guys, this is what we're going to look at. So join me, we get started. Now the very first thing I require you guys to do is to write a simple PHP script right here. You can see this is my PHP. This is what shall collect for us the data from the MySQL database, and then code it for us to a JSON format so that we can decode it in our Android application. Now you can see, for instance, my host 127.0.0.1. I'm having the username right here, root as the root password, and of course my database. Now my SQL connect, I pass those particular properties. If I have an error, I display the error right here. My SQL statement, select everything from Spacecraft DB. We're just going to select everything on the go. Okay, yeah, we're just going to select everything, and then we're just going to only connect once and then select all the data that we need, so that if the user clicks, we just display the data from our main activity. So that's it. Right here we're having a MySQL query. We pass in our connection and the SQL statement, and then what we're going to be doing, we're going to be fetching row by row and then adding them to this particular array. Then at the end of the day we come and code the array and encode that array into a JSON format. Okay, and then close our connection. So if we run our application, if we run Android application, what we're going to do, we're going to end up with a JSON string. Okay, a JSON string that we're going to be formatting. So guys, this is it. Please just write it. Now once you've written the PHP script, make sure that you save it actually in the root directory for your server. Now for me, for instance, you can see I'm having my WAMP server. You can save it either in your www directory or just create a folder. Like for me, I've just created a folder right here, and then you can see right here I've saved my PHP script over there. So guys, that's it. Please make sure that you do that one so that we get started. Now go ahead, create your Android application. I'm using Android Studio 1.5.1. application name, type the application name, then come choose your minimum SDK right here. Then we go, we have templates. I'll go with the blank template. You click next, then click finish to generate for us our project. Okay, so guys, after load the images, so I'm going to use the Picasso library. So come over it in your build.cred, then make sure that you add this one. Okay, com .square.picasso. Picasso, I think I don't know, I'm not sure if this is the latest version, but you can check it out or you can just add it this way. Okay. Then once we've done that one, the grid view that you are seeing consisted of the CAD views, so make sure so that you add the CAD view support library. Once we've done this one, then come and then sync your project. Okay, so sync your project is going to add the necessary classes to our project. Now once we've done that one, let's move to our app right here. Let's start with the manifest. We shall be connecting to a network, so because of that one, I'm going to need you guys to add make sure that you add the permission for the internet, android.permission.internet. I come over right here, then add it. Okay, so once we've done added that one, then we're going to move to our resources. First let's add a placeholder image. This is the image that shall be shown where we are downloading our image. Okay, it's our image placeholder. Now once we're downloading our image from the database, we shall manually show this particular placeholder image. Also if you specify the wrong URL, okay, if you're unable to download the image, you shall simply show our placeholder image instead of showing an error. So that's it guys, that's it. Now the next thing, we're going to move to our layout. So for the layouts, of course, Android Studio shall automatically generate for you these two particular layouts right here. If I come to activity main and then content main, of course we know right here activity main, our template layout to include our content main. Then we also have the content main where we're going to be including actually our detail view. So if you come right here to our detail view, you can see detail view. If we come out right here to our content main, we're going to have our grid view right here. You can see we're giving it an ID, GV, then the number of columns for us, which is going to be 3 in this case. Okay, so then apart from those ones, I've just pre-added some of my other, you can see I've just added 2 layouts right here. My activity, these are the layouts for my detail activity. Okay, remember we're going to have, now for us of course the master activity shall consist of these 2, our detail activity then shall also consist of this one. Then this model layout, this is the model for my custom grid view. Okay, now for instance of course our grid view shall consist of images and text. You can see right here it's going to consist of the CAD view. You can see my image view and then of course the text view right here. It's that simple. Then for this one's activity detail, you can see it's also the template layout for my detail activity. I'm including the content detail. Now inside my content detail, I've pre-designed it to save us some time. You can see right here I'm having a CAD view. Now in my CAD view, as you can see, first I'm having the image view that you are seeing at the top. Okay, I'm scaling it to a center crop. Then right here I have a couple of text views, for instance the name label and then of course the name txt right here. Then you also have the propellant label and then of course the propellant txt and then of course the description label and then description txt right here with some text, initial text. Okay, I don't know whether it shall be able to render. Let's see. Alright, now here you can see we have our image view. We have, for instance, you can see the label and then of course the name itself, propellant, the propellant itself, description, then the description right here. So this is the way our detail view shall look. You can see right here at the top our image, then everything right here. So please, you can design yours the way you like. So that's it. Those are our layouts. Please make sure that you design all your layouts as you wish. Then we now move to our code. So in our code first, as usual, we're going to organize our code in packages. My first package right here, I'm going to have m data object, where we're going to be having our Pujo class. So in this case, I'll be dealing with spacecraft once more. So I'm going to come right here, create a spacecraft class. So that's it. That's my spacecraft. It shall hold the spacecraft details like the name, the ID, images, etc. for us. So then once we've done that one, we're going to move to the next package right here. We're going to have MySQL. Right here we're going to have classes dealing with our MySQL database. So for instance, the first class that we're going to have, we shall need to connect to our database. So we're going to have the connector class. It shall connect to the database, returning for us an HTTP URL connection object, okay, which we're going to be using in our downloader class. Now, downloader class right here, this is where we shall be downloading our data from the database. And then, of course, lastly, the data that we've downloaded shall be in the form of JSON format. Then we shall just pass it inside our data parser class. So guys, remember, right here we are dealing with a grid view. So I'm going to have right here MUI package. The first thing, this is a custom grid view with an image and text. So for that one, we're going to have a custom adapter class. Now custom adapter, okay, where we're going to bind our data to a grid view. So once we have that one, we also shall be using Picasso to load our images. So why don't we have a Picasso client? This is going to help us download our images efficiently to our image view. So that's it. The first class that we're going to need. In fact, let's come right here. Remember, the detail activity also going to need a detail activity. So lastly, let's come right here, create for it. Detail activity. Now this is why we are creating so many classes. These are very simple classes. It's easier to explain and also to organize our code well this way. So for activity, we're just going to come right here, then choose our blank activity. Okay, now for blank activity, of course, this one right here, we're going to call it detail activity. It's going to generate for us another layout, which we in of course we're going to delete because we already have our layout. So just add the detail activity over right here. Alright, now it's generated for us this particular layout. We don't need it already, we have our content detail. So let's come and delete these ones. We had already pre-designed our layouts right here. Okay, so the content detail right here, and of course the activity detail too. So this is it. We're going to make sure that we delete these ones. Okay, let me just make sure that it's registered in our manifest. So m detail activity. Okay, of course for this one also, we're going to need to come right here, change this one to activity detail. And then inside our manifest, yeah, it's registered. So this is it, guys. This is it. Let's now come and then move to our code. The first thing with our spacecraft, these are simple applications going to consist of spacecrafts. Now for us, int id, our spacecraft shall consist of several data. Then I'm going to have a string name. Okay, in fact, name, we shall also have propellant. We're going to have the description. So description. Then lastly, we're going to have the image URL. So all these ones are we're going to have their getters and setters right here. These are data object class. Okay, so yeah, this is we're going to generate their getters and setters. Okay, this class, its purpose is very simple to hold for us these particular details. So yeah, yes, that's it, guys. That's our spacecraft class. The next thing, the next class that we're going to deal with, let's come to our connector class. Now for our connector, this one right here, we're going to have one simple method. Let's make it static. It's going to return for us an HTTP URL connection. The method itself, we're going to call it connect. Now, what shall we be connecting to? Okay, let's pass the URL address onto which we shall be connecting to. Then the first thing that we're going to do right here, let's come over right here, say URL java.net.url URL equal to new URL. We pass the URL address that we've just specified right here. So with this one, we'll need to catch a malformed URL exception. Then we're going to have right here HTTP URL connection con equal to URL dot open connection. Then we come catch the exception. Then of course cast this one to HTTP URL connection. So yes, after that one, we're going to come right here, specify the connection properties. Now first con, we set request method. We're going to make a get request. So then we're also going to come set its connect timeout. Now our timeout, I'll be using 20k milliseconds. Then con dot set read timeout, the same way I'll also use 20k milliseconds. Then con dot set do input. Of course our connection is going to support input for us. Then of course we come right here, return our connection. Okay, otherwise if we have an error, then I'm gonna return null. So return null. That's it. This is our connector class. It's a simple class. The method is going to return for us a connection once a HTTP URL connection object, once we've established the connection to the network. Alright, let's come over now to our downloader class. Of course, once we've established our connection, the next thing we want to do is to download the data that we want to display. So yes, we come our downloader. Of course, the downloading of data, we're going to perform it in a background thread. So come void. Void we derive from async task. Now within this class, we're going to have a context. We shall need a context. We're going to need the URL address, okay, into which we shall pass to our connector class. Then lastly, we shall come over right here. Then we're going to need, of course, the grid view onto which we shall want to bind our data. So GV over right here, okay. Shall also be showing a progress dialog while downloading, so let's just have it right here. So okay, these three ones right here, we shall be obtaining them via the constructor. So let's come over here. The three via the constructor. Then inside our own pre-execute, we shall come then initialize our progress dialog. So progress dialog, set title. What's our title? Okay, the title for our progress dialog, we're going to say retrieve. This is what we are going to be doing. Then pd add set message. What's the message? We're going to say retrieving, please wait. This is our message. So yes, once we've done that one, then pd dot show. Of course, we wanna show the progress dialog. Okay, now take note that this one pre-execute shall be done in the background thread, not on the background thread, on the UI thread. This is the one where you can see right here, we are displaying a progress dialog. Okay, so we shall start by showing our progress dialog. Then of course, meanwhile, the doing background method shall be called after the on pre-execute. Okay, so this is where the job that you want to do in the background shall take place inside the doing background. So meanwhile, once the job is over, we shall come right here. The on post execute method shall be called as well. It shall also be done in the UI thread. So the first thing that you're going to be doing right here, you can see right here, we specified at the top parameters right here, the string. Now what we specify, this is what the doing background method shall return. Yes, we specify that it's going to return for us a string. Now this string that's going to return for us, of course, we shall be passed to our own post execute as a result. Okay, so in this case for us, it shall just be a JSON data that shall be passed for us that has been downloaded, because remember we are downloading our data, so JSON data. Okay, so once it's been passed right here, okay, we shall be able to pass it to our parser class, data parser, for it to be passed. Now the first thing we wanna do over right here is to make sure that we dismiss our progress dialog. Remember we had started it, so we have to dismiss it or else shall be shown forever. So yes, we have that one, guys, but then we also need to come implement how specifically we're going to be downloading our data. So come right here, download data. Now the first thing, okay, by default, let me return null. The first thing that you want to do before downloading our data, of course, is to establish our connection. Okay, we have our connector class. To help us do so, you simply pass the URL address. But then there's a possibility that our connection can be null. So if it is null, we're not going to try to download data yet we have a null connection. We're simply going to return null and exit. Otherwise, if that's not the case, then we shall come over right here. We shall obtain our input stream from our connection. Okay, equal to new buffered input stream, then con dot get input stream. With this one, we have to capture our IO exception. So then, once we've done that one, we shall need a buffered reader. This shall help us read this data. So come right here, buffered. Nope. Reader, then br equal to new buffered reader. Of course, for our input stream, we have to read it using an input stream reader object. So let's come right here, new input stream reader, then we pass in our input stream. So yes, we have that one. The first thing, we are going to be reading our data line by line. Okay, now we shall store a single line inside this particular string, but then at the end of the day we shall want all our JSON data. So we're going to have right here a string buffer. Okay, so string buffer equal to new a string buffer. So these lines, we shall just be appending them to this string buffer that we are calling JSON data. Okay, now to read our data, let's come while line, as we shall be reading them, we shall be reading dynamically, and then of course assigning it to this our line string right here. And of course we shall also be checking if it is not null. So while line is not equal to null, line equal to br.readline, then we shall come right here, JSON data, we come and then append our data line right here, and then we shall be appending them line by line. So that's it, guys, that's it. They shall going to give us at the end of the day a JSON data, which is a string buffer. But then the first thing that we want to do is to make sure that we release the resources by, okay, we close our buffered reader, then we also close our input stream, and then of course come over here and then return our JSON data. Okay, we need to return it as a string, so we make sure that we cast it. This is just simple. That's how we're going to be downloading our data. To execute it, of course we just come right here and say this dot download data, and that's it. Otherwise we shall come over right here. The first thing, we want to make sure if whatever is returned is null. Now before we try passing, let's try to see if it is null. We are not going to call our parser class to pass our data. Instead, we are gonna just display a simple toast saying unable. Okay, let's just say unsuccessful. Okay, then no data retrieved. There may be a whole reasons for this, a whole list of issues that may cause this one to occur. For instance, if your connection, if you didn't establish a connection, you're going to return null, okay? Or if you have, for instance, an IO exception, then also null shall be returned. So that's it. No data retrieved. Then we come right here. Then it's a toast. So we just show it. Otherwise, if this is not the case, then it means that, yes, we have our data. Now we shall just call our parser class to pass the data. But then for our parser class, let's come define. Depending on the amount of data you have, this one right here, shall also need for us to come and then do it also in the background thread passing for us, okay? Because it can also be time consuming. So let's come over here. First thing, we shall also need a context, okay? We are also going to need what, of course, the JSON data that you want to pass. Then, of course, the grid view that we want to bind our data to, the data that we've just passed. Once more, okay, we can just display a progress dialog to make the user see what is going on. Now, we shall come, choose these three right here, and then we'll pre-execute. The first thing also right here, we are going to pd equal to initialize our progress dialog equal to new progress dialog, passing in our context. So pd dot set title. Now what's our title? Our title in this case is going to be okay passing. Let's just have it as pass. Then pd dot set our message. What's our message? Passing wait. Then of course we call the show method. Okay. Yeah, on pre-execute. Now once the on pre-execute method is called, the next method that's going to be called of course is the doing background. This way we shall perform our actual passing. We've not yet defined how to pass, we shall do so in a short while. Then at the end of the day, once the passing is over, we're going to come call our on post execute. So on post execute, as you can see right here, is taking a boolean. No, the boolean right here that is taking is getting it from our doing background. But then the doing background, you can see right here, we specified that it's going to return for us a boolean. So yes, we're going to come this boolean actually was going to it's just going to check for us if we've successfully passed our data. Why are we doing that one? We're doing that one because we only want to try to bind data if we've successfully passed. If we have an exception, we shall just not try to display our data so that we avoid our application crashing every time. Now let's come over here for instance and then check if passed. Okay, that is if it is passed. Okay, we shall now call our custom adapter to bind. Otherwise, if this is not the case, then once more a simple toast will do for us. So in this case it's unable to pass. Okay, then length, and then we show it. So that's it. Now of course we come and then define how we are going to be passing. So let's come right here, private void pass data. So for our passing of data right here, we are also going to wrap it inside in a try catch block. So let's come over right here, say try, then JSON array JA equal to new JSON array. We pass in our JSON data. So come right here, JSON data. We have to catch the JSON exception, and then this is it. Of course, we're also going to just declare a JSON object. Now our JSON array shall be consisting of JSON objects. But then the data that we shall be passing, for us actually each JSON object shall be equivalent, shall correspond to a single spacecraft. And then right here we are going to be having an array list into which we shall be adding all these spacecrafts that we've just first of spacecrafts equal to new array list. Just instantiate it over there. Then at the end of the day, we shall come over right here. The first thing we want to make sure is to clear our spacecrafts. Okay. So once we've done that one, we're going also to come right here, spacecraft. Just declare a single spacecraft object that's going to hold for us the data that we passed. But then we come right here, we have our array int. We're going to loop through it, I less than j a dot length. Then so what next? Okay, we obtain a single JSON object, j a equal to get a JSON object. We pass in the index. So yes, this is going to give us a single JSON object. Now what we're going to need, we're just going to extract the data that we need from it. First, for instance, the ID. Nope. We shall come over here, int ID equal to. Now we have a JSON object. We just call get int. Then we pass in the column name. Now for us, the column name is the ID. Please make sure that for your columns that you are passing over here, this one has to be the exactly the way you have it in your database, or else you're going to have a JSON exception. So a string name, what about the name? The same, get JSON, no, get string, then we come over here, name, and that's it. So that's it. Also, we're also going to have other right here, like the propellant. So I'll just come right here, let me just have it that way, and then of course the description, and lastly we shall have the image URL. So image URL, this one, nope, image URL, and then of course this one, a description. Now guys, you have to be very keen. These ones right here, these are the column names, the way you have them in your database. So just make sure that it is exactly the way you have them in the database name. So propellant, we shall have it. This is the way I have it. Okay. So yes, at the end of the day, we have these particular properties of our spacecraft. Now we just instantiate a spacecraft and then add them in. Now spacecraft equal to new spacecraft, then we set all these data. So for instance, we come, if we start with the ID, spacecraft dot set ID, no ID, spacecraft dot set name, then we pass in the name, then spacecraft dot set propellant, propellant, and then of course spacecraft let's set description. We pass in the description, then spacecraft dot set image URL. We pass in our image URL. So yes, we have those particular properties. We set them to our spacecraft object. Now we simply need to add this particular spacecraft object to our spacecraft's collection. That's it. At the end of the day, we're going to come right here, return. We're going to return true. I hope we specified to return a boolean. Let's come now. Yeah, let's come over right here. Let's make this one return a boolean. So true if we've been successful, if we've successfully passed our data. Otherwise, we're going to return false. Okay. So I showed you the importance of that one. You can see right here, if we've passed, this is when we shall be able to bind our data. Otherwise, we shall just show a simple post message. All right, so that's going to do for us. The next thing is, we're going to work with the UI stuff. Let's come over here, start with the custom adapter. So custom adapter, this is going to be a custom grid view. So we come, we need an adapter for it. Our adapter is going to take two things. First, a context object. And then the context object shall help us when instantiating our layout in Flutter. Now we shall also come right here. We're also going to need what we're going to need, actually the data source. In this case, just a simple array list that's going to consist of our spacecraft. Now we're going to call it spacecrafts. So, okay, they shall be passed to us via the constructor. So then get count as spacecrafts dot size, and then get item right here as spacecrafts dot get, then we pass in the position. This is going to return for us a single spacecraft. So ID, let's use the position as the ID. Then this one right here, we're going to be returning a convert view. So yes, the first thing we're going to do over here, we shall check if our convert view is null. That's when we shall be able to inflate our layout. So convert view equal to layout inflator dot from, then we pass in our context, then inflate no r dot layout. Okay, so yes, dot layout, it is the mode layout that we want to inflate. We're inflating it from a single item in our grid view. Then what's our view group? The parent are false. We're not going to be attaching it to some other root view. So yes, this is it. We have this one over here. Now the first thing, we're going to need a text view name txt convert view dot find view by id r dot id dot name txt. Then we're going to pass, that's it. Of course, we're going to cast this one to a text view. So we're also going to need an image view that shall be used to show the image that we want to display. Okay, so for this case of this one, it's going to be an image view. I'm going to call it img. So we come right here, image view, then for me it's nope, actually it's a spacecraft image. So yes, that's going to do for us. Now guys, the next thing is to of course bind our data. Now for us, let's come first get a single spacecraft object s equal to this dot get item. Remember, we have this particular method get item that's going to return for us an object representing our spacecraft. So we simply pass in the position it gives us our spacecraft, but then it returns for us an object, so we make sure that we cast it to a spacecraft. Okay, a spacecraft object. All right, so now we have that one. Let's come start with the name txt set text s dot get name, and then right here, what about the image? Okay, for our image, you're going to lazy load it using our Picasso client class right here. So let's just come have this method, it's not returning anything, we're calling it download image. That's what it's going to do for us. So context, then we going to have what next? Of course, the image URL. So we come over right here, and lastly our image view. So yes, the first thing we wanna check if our image URL is null. Okay, if it is not null, and of course image URL dot length greater than zero. If that's not the case, that is if it is null, then what are you going to do? You're simply going to display our Picasso, no, our placeholder. So come right here and then load our dribble. Okay, so our dribble dot placeholder. Okay, we're going to load it to our image view. Otherwise, if that's not the case, then of course we shall just load it directly from our URL. Now load then image URL. While loading, we shall also be able to show our placeholder, and then of course into the image view. That's it guys, that's it, that's our Picasso client. Of course, to apply it, you simply come over here and then just pass in Picasso client dot download image, passing in our context, then we pass in of course our image URL, then the image view, and that's it. That's how we're going to do our stuff. So this does it, that's going to do for us. Let's come to our data parser. So to bind our data, custom adapter, adapter equal to new custom adapter. Then what do we pass in? We pass in our context, we also pass in our spacecraft collection. Then we simply come GV dot set adapter, we pass in our adapter. And that's it. Of course, for our downloader, we're just going to come over here. No, for parser, first data parser. Nope. So, data parser, parser equal to new data parser right here. Then, of course, we pass in our context. We're going to pass in also what our URL. No, we needed to pass in our JSON data. And then of course a grid view, then parser.execute to start our async task. This does it, but then we are not yet through. Remember, what we want is very simple. We want, this is a master detail stuff, so we need to handle the item click event for our list view, and then in that case open our detail activity. Now for us to do that one, let's come over right here. Just come here and say convert view to set item click listener. Okay, remember this convert view, this is going to represent a single item in our grid view. So convert view dot set on click listener equal to new on click listener. Okay, so this is how we're going to be handling our item on click listener, because remember this is a custom grid view. So in this case, what we want to do right here, okay, is simple. We shall simply want to display, of course, open our detail activity. But how do we do that one? Let's come right here and define. So now private void open detail activity. So open detail activity. There are some things that shall be passing to our detail activity. Remember, we are passing some data from our master activity. First is the name, it shall be displayed. Then we also have our propellant. We have the description. And lastly, we have, of course, the image URL. This shall be used to load our image. So these are the things that we're going to be passing. Now for us to open an activity, first we're going to use we're going to need an intent right here equal to new intent. Then what's the class? Of course, the context first. Now the context in this case is going to be C, and then detail activity dot class. So yes, we have our intent. We pack our data to be sent. Now for us in this case, I dot put extra. Then first to specify the key that shall be used to retrieve that particular data. Now for us, for instance, the name key, then just come right here, say name. Okay, we're going to do the same thing for the others, therefore of them. So we have the name right here, then you're also going to have our propellant. So come right here and propellant. Then right here we're going to have our description, and lastly we shall have our image URL. So for image URL, for instance, we're going to have our image URL, a description, we're going to have our description, and then of course the propellant, we're going to have our propellant. Okay, then to finish things up, we start the activity. So come right here, C, let's start activity, then we pass in our intent. So this is how we shall be sending data to a detail activity. We have a more detailed master detail tutorials. You can just check our channel. We have a master detail playlist. So that's it. This is going to do for us. Now what we simply do right here, we come, just call our open detail activity. Okay. Then of course name equal to s.getName. This one we need to make it final. So s.getName that's going to give us the name s.get our propellant, then s.get description, and lastly s.get image URL. So does it now? That's how we're going to be sending out this particular data. But remember, to show them, we need to receive them inside right here and then show them. Now for us, of course, to show them, first for the text views, we shall need the text views to show them right here. So name txt, also going to need the propellant txt to show the propellant. Then we have the description txt to show the description. We shall need an image view as well, onto which our image shall be loaded onto. So yes, we have those ones. Now the next thing, we come right here. Let's come name txt equal to our find view by id r.id. At this time round, it's going to be name txt detail. So we cast this one to a text view. So we're also going to have, of course, a description txt. In this case, it's going to be a description detail txt, and then a propellant txt. In this case, a propellant detail txt. Then lastly, we have our image right here. We're going to have an image view, spacecraft image. So that's it, guys. Then we come, we receive our data. Now to receive them, we once more going to need an intent, but then this time round we just get it from our main activity, from our detail activity right here, this dot get intent. Okay, now the first thing, we come right here, we want to extract the name. So name equal to I, okay, dot get extras, then get string. Now in this case, we just pass in the key, which is our name key. That's going to do for us. We're going to do the same thing for the others. Now apart from the name right here, we're going to need a propellant. This one right here should be this way. So yes, propellant, we're also going to need the description, and then lastly we're going to need the image URL. Okay, so image URL over right here, then right here we have our disk. Okay, if you come right here, of course we just specify the URL that we have specified. Now in this case, going to be image URL. Just make sure that you specify the key the way you specified it while we were sending it. Then of course right here we call it description key, and then we have our propellant over here. Great, that's going to do for us. We have all these zones right here. Now the next thing, once we've received them, of course, is to now bind them to our views. So name txt, no name txt, let's set text, then name the same thing with our propellant txt, set text propellant. Okay, then of course we also have the description txt, let's set text description. Then lastly, for our image, now how do we deal with the image? Remember, we have our Picasso client, we just call it download image. We pass in the context in this case, which is this. Then we have our image URL already. Then we just pass in the image view, and that's it. That's going to do for us, guys. So yes, that's it. Now the next thing, let's jump to our main activity. The first thing, we need to specify the URL that we shall be connecting to. So come right here, static a string, I'm going to call it URL address. Then we come right here, now HTTP. Ok okay, 10.0.2.200, then a spacecraft, okay, spacecraft, select, this is the way I called mine, select images.php. So please write here, specify the path that is pointing you to your PHP file. Then we come over here, we're going to have final grid view, gv equal to find view by id, r.id.gridview. Okay, now once you've done that one, then you simply come over right here in our own click. We say a new downloader, we set our downloader to download for us. We pass, of course, the context, which is main activity. This pass in our URL address, and then lastly, we pass in our grid view. Then we make sure that we start this particular async task right here by calling the execute. So, guys, does it once more? I'll repeat, make sure that you are right here, you've added the permission for connection to the internet. And also make sure that your server is up and running. So that's it, guys. Let's run our project so that we have a look. Great, guys. Here we have our project after running it. Now just make sure that your server is up and running. Then we come, we click our fab button. Okay, we have an error. Let's come and see what is it that we've done. So if we come over right here, you can see data parser in post execute null pointer exception. If passed, okay, and we can just have see right here, we are returning null. So let's come right here, guys. Just come and say return this dot pass data. This is the only mistake that we made. So let's come right here, then rerun our project and see what it has for us. And yes, guys, here we have our project. Now we come, click our fab button right here. Okay, it retrieves, then passes our data, and then right here. Okay, I'm seeing we've also missed another thing. Let's just come and correct it. So in the first thing, once of course we had shown our progress dialog, we also have to make sure that we dismiss it. So please just make sure that you add this one. Let me just not assume anything, we just make sure that we have it right here, and then have it again. All right, this same round we come, okay, very first we have our data right here. Now if we come, click a single item, okay, another error. Let's come and see. So if we come right here, we can see that what today we're making so many errors. Now java.lang.null okay, runtime exception. We're having a runtime exception. It's pointing us to the Picasso client right here. Okay, so Picasso.read, and then okay, what is it saying? Target for us, it's telling us that the target is null. So let's come in our detail activity. Okay, right here. Now this image view, this should be spacecraft detail image. Please make sure that we assign it the image view that you had in your detail activity. Okay. So now let's still see what it has for us. All right, so we come, click a single item, click our fab button. Now this time round, if we come click, you can see right here, it loads it for us very fast. You can see right here, we have our image, we have our name, we have the propellant, okay? Just the way we have them in our database. If you come to enterprise, you can see now everything is all right, everything is working smoothly. Okay, so guys, this is it. This is the master detail view with MySQL database. Actually, some guys had requested this particular tutorial, so I'm hoping you guys their questions have been answered. Okay, I'm hoping you guys have enjoyed this particular tutorial. Please, if you have, go ahead, hit the subscribe button, hit the like button. Okay, share it for me with friends and family. And guys, do take care. I'll catch you in the next tutorial.